Welcome to the Roaring Twenties Lecture Series, Art Deco in Argentina. Let's tango. I'm Sharon Koskoff, president of the Art Deco Society of the Palm Beaches, and we're here tonight on Zoom to talk about the World Congress held in November 2019 in Buenos Aires, Argentina. It's the World Congress from the International Coalition of Art Deco Societies. We chose tonight, June 16th, 2021, because something exciting happened. At the International Exposition des Arts Décoratifs et Industrielles Modernes, there was a dancer, and the dancer's name was Loie Fuller. And she was an Art Nouveau dancer, and she danced at the Exposition Universal in 1900 in Paris. And they built a fairgrounds, including the Trocadero, the Eiffel Tower, as we see here. This is the Universal Exposition in 1900. And it was a celebration of the past and into the future. And this is Loie Fuller. She's this marvelous Art Nouveau dancer. And what was so interesting, she was so famous that she was the only single person to have her own pavilion at the Expo in France. Everything else was different, you know, a country, but she as a dancer with her pavilion, and we see the Art Nouveau waves and organic structure. Rodin was enamored with her and did many sculptures. Toulouse-Lautrec did many posters of La Loie Fuller. And we see her flowing around. Here we see a Toulouse-Lautrec poster, and I'd like to show you a video. She was so ahead of her time that La Loie Fuller actually took, this is in the 1800s. Loie Fuller was one of the most innovative artists. She was known as a skirt dancer, a fairy dance, the fire dance. She combined light effects. She was known for the serpentine dance. We can see this is Art Nouveau. We see the circles and swirling. We see the femininity. They called her a snake charmer. But she did all of her own production, lighting design. She was an American from Chicago. She came to Paris with the Isadora Duncan dancers. She was gay. Her life partner was Gabriel Bloch. And she swirled into the hearts of Paris. So she was welcomed, and she always performed at the Folies Bergères, and she was the symbol of Art Nouveau movement. So this is where she played on June 16th, 1925, which is 96 years ago. Loie Fuller played the Grand Palais, the Grand Palace, at the Beaux-Arts Style Cultural Arts Center. This was the grand entrance to the Art Deco exposition that we know from 1925. The reason I wanted to show this is because we're talking about Argentina and we're talking about tango. So art is a reflection of society, whether it's visual arts or dance or movement. So tango began in the 1880s in Argentina, and it was very immoral and working class. And men would dance with men while they were waiting for prostitutes in the brothels. But by the 1920s, it became very popular in Paris. And we just saw the feminine fluid dance. Let's look at this Art Deco tango. First of all, it's very masculine. And we see straight lines. Look at the straight lines in the dress, the straight lines in the dress. We see triangles in the legs. We see triangles in the body. We see balance. What's on the left is on the right. And the tango, which is very, very masculine. You could say that tango is Art Deco and opposite the Art Nouveau of Loie Fuller. The most famous French-Argentine king of tango was named Carlos Gardel. So we're going to talk about the International Coalition of Art Deco Societies. There are about 35 current Art Deco societies around the world. As you can see in the United States, the Art Deco Society of the Palm Beaches. We're here to talk about South America today, Art Deco Buenos Aires, Argentina. But just look at the wealth in Europe, Australia, New Zealand, Africa, Asia, all of the continents have Art Deco societies. So Barbara Bayer Kapitman in 1991 in Miami Beach started the International Coalition of Art Deco Societies. And she said that all of the Art Deco societies should get together like every 2 years and network and travel around the world and see other cities and cultures and see the Art Deco modern architecture. So we're going to visit the 2019 Buenos Aires, Argentina conference. But the good news that I'm here to say and announce, in 2 years, in 2023, the Palm Beaches will be the site for the pre-Congress. It'll be April 28th, 29th, and 30th of April 2023. So now I have 2 years not to sleep so I can, you know, show everyone the riches of Palm Beach County. In 2025, ICADS, the International Coalition of Art Deco Societies, hopes to have its Congress in Paris for the 100th anniversary of the exposition. Wow, this is very, very exciting time for me. Here's Barbara Kapitman in Miami. She wrote the two books, Deco Delights, and she passed away before she finished her second book, Rediscovering Art Deco USA, and Michael Knurk and Dennis Wilhelm with photos of Randy Jester. They finished the book for her. But when I went to Barbara, she said to me, let me show you what Art Deco is. Art Deco in the Palm Beaches is actually what we call streamlined modern, the absence of man's idiosyncratic embellishments. And we see this here. She showed me this building in San Francisco. So we see the straight lines. We see rounded corners for speed. We see one, two, three. We'll see groups of three. We'll see on, what's on the left is on the right, so a group of three windows on the left. We see stepping up like a pyramid and stepping down. And notice how it gets smaller and smaller? We call that stepping back. So we see the stepping back times three. Below here, we'll see three portholes. This is a roof view of the nautical building that's in the water. It's now called the San Francisco Maritime Museum. This is across from Ghirardelli Square in San Francisco. But it has all of the elements of what to look for in Art Deco architecture. So I met, of course, Michael and Dennis. We had a big Palm Beach party in a private residence, and they came on up in the home of Cobre Clewis, which was 1221 North Lake Way, all the way in the 90s. And I met with Leonard Horowitz, who was Barbara's friend, who started the Miami Design Preservation League. He was an architectural colorist. He designed 150 Art Deco buildings in South Beach. And he and I traveled together to Cincinnati for the National Trust for Historic Preservation. In September 1988, we shared a room, and he died shortly after in May 5th, 1989 of AIDS. But he did all of the colors that we think of in South Beach, the pastel paradise. So I come back to Palm Beach and I start painting. I'm a mural artist and designer. I paint the Jazz Man, which becomes our logo. The ADSPB, which is the Art Deco Society of the Palm Beaches. Here's the Jazz Man, along with Drusilla and Melody, which are three serigraphs, which are silk screens that I made. And in New York, I was a member of the Art Deco Society of New York. Dennis Abbey was the founder. He created this poster. And I worked on this program in 1984 before I moved to Florida, where we see here the Chrysler Building with these, you know, masculine animals of the eagle with the one, two, three, and the little stepping back facing the Empire State Building. Here we see the Chrysler Building. We see those triangles that I was telling you about with Tango and 1930 William Van Allen. Empire State Building, see how it steps back? Okay, here's a full view, 1931, Shreve, Lamb, and Harmon. And this is the Art Deco Society of New York on their website, where they show the buildings, the skyscraper reaching its heights. I wrote then the book, Art Deco of the Palm Beaches for Arcadia Publishing, which you can always get a signed copy. But let's start with Art Nouveau, because we're talking about Art Nouveau and Art Deco. So Art Nouveau is the 1890s to the 1910s. We think of it of Antonio Gaudi, the Sagrada Familia, which is a church in Barcelona. And we see this organic growing to the sky, this natural, okay, like bones. This is like a vertebrae. This is the interior roof. Okay, so first we saw Loie Fuller dancing, like a butterfly and wings. And here we see bone structure. We see the Art Nouveau. We see peacocks and women with flowing hair and long gowns and hair intertwined on the Job cigarette papers. We see this doorway in France. No straight lines, right? No straight lines in Art Nouveau. It's the revolution of Art Deco where we begin to see the geometric straight lines. And here in France, we'll see the floor tile swirling. So the Art Nouveau was a feminine swirling natural time. If you've ever been to Winter Park in Florida, the most wonderful Morse Museum has Tiffany collection, room after room of these spider web designs and flowers, trees growing, dragonfly, just amazing. Amazing Morse Museum. I've been there about 5 times. So, and as a reminder, here we see Loie Fuller swirling through the outside. But by 1922, Howard Carter discovered King Tut's tomb, and all the rage becomes Egyptian. So by 1925, at the International Exposition des Arts Décoratifs et Industrielles Modernes, which took place from April to October, really highlighted the futurism, the geometry, the masculine speed of Art Deco, which was not coined until 1968. So they called it modernism, all right? And they had all kinds of events at this exposition, and we just highlighted the June 16th, Loie Fuller. Okay, so traveling throughout the United States, visiting all these Art Deco societies, we have in Cincinnati, the Carew Tower, which is very similar to like the Empire State Building, inside with relief. We have the circles and the steps of the Cincinnati Museum Center at Union Terminal. This is the inside that looks a lot like Radio City with its concentric circles and warm fire colors of yellows and oranges. In New Orleans, we see the rounded corners of the streamlined Moderna and the glass block, the flat roof. And this was right after Katrina, where they were counting bodies and making sure that there were any people stuck left in these buildings. This blue plate now became an art center. This is also in New Orleans, where we see triangles called the chevron. We see the 1, 2, 3. We see all kinds of triangles and designs and motifs and colorful tile on an endangered building. I hope this building is restored one day, the General Laundry Cleaners Building. And the newly restored Lakefront Airport in New Orleans, with its masculine mythological creatures, 1, 2, 3, and 1, 2, 3, and the stepping up and the stepping down of the pyramid. An amazing building throughout with murals. The Golden Gate Bridge in San Francisco. We see the Stock Exchange in San Francisco with Diego Rivera murals and the 1, 2, 3 family. We even see these stylized, which means to simplify and elongate. We see these cubism, these straight lines in the sculptures. Tony Fusco in Boston, the financial district, the post office building, where we see relief and tall buildings. Paramount Theater in Boston. We lost Rex Ball, who was the head of the Tulsa Art Deco Society, but when I met with him, he showed me the Will Rogers High School and this Tulsa Fire Alarm Building, just a beautiful structure. Los Angeles, we have relief with colored painted stone, the Eastern Building, and of course the flowing with neon at night, the old cars, the rounded corners, the three stripes, the bandings. So there's international societies all over the globe, as we see. What's interesting is there was an earthquake in Australia in 1931, and when they rebuilt, it was the modern style, just like South Beach. We didn't have an earthquake, but that's when construction began in South Beach in the 20s and 30s and 40s. So here you have a city being rebuilt, and it was in this modern style. Here's a picture of the Hawke's Bay region where the Art Deco Societies dress up and for the Tremaine Art Deco Society weekend, Roaring 20s style. And of course, in Miami, we have Tony Goldman, who owned the Park Central Hotel, the 1-2-3s and the verticality and the balance on both sides. Many of you don't know, but Tony's the one who started Wynwood Walls, where all those murals are in Miami, right off I-95. And of course, if we talk about interesting architects, we talk about Maurice Lapidus, who did the pedestrian walkway at Lincoln Road. The Sterling Building is an Art Deco example in the walkway. We see here the 1-2-3 in the rounded corners and fabulous structure. Books and Books is located in this building. In Montreal, we have a church and the University of Montreal. In fact, we're going to see buildings today that look just like this, but they're going to not be universities. They're going to be slaughterhouses. Take a look at this. Okay, in Brazil, the Christ of the Redeemer. All over the world is Art Deco. London Art Deco. Shanghai. Patrick Cranley brought a congress. I could not go. I'm gluten free. I would never be able to eat in China. But they went to China. So Art Deco in China. Look, porthole windows, flat roof, rounded corners, 1-2-3s. And bandings below here at the entrance in China. Geodory Copper Bridge and Gustavo Lopez brought us to Cuba, Habana Deco, where here we see the relief of all the Americas. This is the Americas building, the stepping up of the 1-2-3s. And this was the poster from that conference. This is just an elevator ornament, 1-2-3, and we see it right here. In the Congreso 2013, I went to Cuba. And then I went to France. I was the keynote speaker in Perpignan at their Art Deco Festival. So first I landed in Paris and went to Perpignan and then off to Barcelona. Here I met with Pascal Laurent, who is the president of the Art Deco Society of Paris. And you know, in Paris, they have such amazing architecture, the whole city. It's a big job to convince people that Art Deco is important and needs to be preserved. And he took us to this building with the rounded corners where they do all the drafting of the architectural studios there. This is in Perpignan. Oh, no, excuse me, that was still Paris. And we went to the Palace de la Porte Dorée. That's the immigration building, which is now a history museum and aquarium. If you're in Paris, you have to go to the Louvre, but I only wanted to go see the Egyptian. Actually, I wanted to see this pyramid by I.M. Pei, who passed away recently in the Louvre, the contrast of the new and the modern. And we went to the Egyptian wing and we got lost in there. That museum is the world's largest museum in the Louvre, and you cannot get out once you get in. But I was grateful to see the Egyptian mummies in black and gold. And here I then spoke as the keynote speaker in Perpignan in this Art Deco building. It was gorgeous. Here we are with Philippe Glagier, who's the president Art Deco of Perpignan, who runs the festival. And a lovely, amazing building. And we toured the Perpignan Art Deco, 1-2-3, rounded windows, 1-2-3, flat roofs on the bottom of the patios. So in Egypt, we went to Aswan, Luxor, and Hurghada. And it was my bucket list. A nice Jewish girl from Brooklyn dying to go to Egypt, where the beginning of Art Deco began. So let's go to Argentina. Here we are in the airport. And welcome to the World Congress, November 5 to 15, 2019, the 15th annual. So it's every 2 years. So this is going on for 30 years at this point. Arrive at the hotel, the NH Hotel, built in 1924 in Mar del Plata. This was the pre-Congress. So there's a pre-Congress, a Congress, and then a post-Congress, which I did not attend, which was held in Uruguay. I was tired and I had to go home. This is the view from my window of the Atlantic Ocean. So everyone gathered, still with their luggage. Many people from the Congress have arrived from all over the world in the lobby. And we see these amazing murals by Cesar Bustillo. And we get a tour of the building. And I took this, you know, amazing photographs of staircases and ceilings. They're so sexy, these photos. And we had a wine reception where there were dozens of these paintings. I just fell in love with. I'm just showing you one. But I love the colors of the yellows, oranges, and the blue-green. The black and white tile floor. And we have this wonderful dinner, and they show us a slide presentation. And we don't really understand what we're looking at, but it says slaughterhouses, and it says cemeteries. And, you know, I had recognized this because I'd done some research before I went to this conference. And I'm like, oh, I hope we get to see that. But little did I know, our first stop would be the next morning at this lovely little bridge, kind of treehouse over a little waterway. And it was the architecture of Amancio Williams. And inside were all of his maquette structures from all the architecture he had built. So it's like a mini museum in his home where he used to live. We have lunch at the Ocean Yacht Club at Mar del Plata, this Art Deco structure. We're all walking along the beach to get to the lunch, the main entrance, where we see the rounded, you might call it an eyebrow entrance. An eyebrow is a flat linear plane. We see the flat roof. We see the center entrance, a little stepping up and stepping down. Here's a postcard, an old postcard. And always these very, very interesting stairway photographs. And then we get to see our first cemetery by Francisco Salamone architect. And this is basically what the entire pre-Congress is, the architecture of Francisco Salamone. Now this is a wide angle. That's why it's rounded, but it's a straight building, and RIP is for rest in peace. And we get to see his architecture. Well, so we see these little, they're actually kind of eyebrows, little steps of ornament, straight lines everywhere. Even the lettering is very straight. And then we're all running around the cemetery for an hour. They let us loose, and we're taking pictures of all these mausoleums and burial graves. And this one, of course, was very stylized in an Art Deco pattern. When we leave, we get back on the bus, we notice this, kind of a fence made out of stone. Well, it turns out that this is Salamone's signature. All of his buildings, the bottom of the buildings, have the stone with this very wide concrete outline. So we'll see more of this. Kind of looks like a beehive. So as we're going to our next location, our bus driver, we're driving on a road, and all of a sudden he takes us, we drive around on La Barossa Speedway. Apparently Brazilians love car racing and are very famous for that. We get to the next Salamone in Balcarce, and here's all our people. Everyone's taking pictures. It's the biblioteca, is a library. And we already can see this is Salamone architecture. And remember, along the bottom here, I showed you that natural stone that contrasts the hard edge geometry straight lines of the building. Okay, they're always in pure white, right? And a contrast with this stone. And of course we go in, a little rounded vertical eyebrows, just all ornament. And inside we see incredible iron works on the staircase and black and white tile floors. So I wander off onto my own and I discover this Museo de Automobilissimo, which is the auto museum, right next to that old, old library. And I walk into this super high tech, look at this, this three-story extravaganza museum. And it turns out this was on our trip and everybody else joined us there very shortly. In the museum, we see Juan Manuel Fangio, and this is all coffee pods, right? Those coffee pods in the current coffee pot of his portrait, along with all these cars. It was a car delight. And they invited us for espresso in the building, the museum, and we enjoyed having a break. Next stop, Salamone, was the Centro Cultural in Valcarce. And again, we see these 1, 2, 3. We see the strong 1, 2, 3 vertical and horizontal stripes. When I spoke in France, I did not speak a bit of French, but I do able to say un, deux, trois. So I was able to communicate with the French audience. But here is the Francisco Salamone Slaughterhouse of Valcarce. And we see rounded circles. And of course, there it is, the bottom. The brickwork, the masonry, right there and there. And what was being served for lunch? It's, you know, Buenos Aires meat. So they just open up a fire anywhere and cook meat. And that's what you have for lunch. Mm-mm, barbecue. And we eat meat. The Planeta Salamone. So here there was an exhibit and some music while we were having lunch. Next hotel, and I do not recommend this hotel. This was like the worst nightmare hotel, the Grand Hotel Azul. But this is where we had to stay. You know, we were hours away on our way to Buenos Aires from Mar del Plata. And but this is where we stayed. And our next stop was here. And we see all this wonderful tile work at the Francisco Salamone exhibit. He's known for his lampposts. All of the structures that we see, he'll design these lampposts. They'll have four lights and a pole. And as we're driving on the bus for hours at a time, we just see cows in pastures, which is, you know, Buenos Aires, Argentina is known for its meat. And we know why. And we arrive in Saldungari. And, you know, all these structures start to look alike, which is really wonderful. You know, and here we see the masonry along the wall here. And a clock is in this one. You know, they all kind of need a pressure cleaning and a painting, but we arrive. And everywhere we go, we're saluted. You know, I hear they're all dressed up in 1940s clothing and they're singing and they have wine and cheese. And you know, it's a big reception. Even if we're only stopping for a half hour, everywhere we go, you know, we're the International Coalition of Art Deco Societies. This is a big thing that we're visiting them. And finally, everyone walks away and I get to take a picture without anyone in the way, which is very difficult. Then we walk to this park in front of the building and everyone's taking pictures. These are some school children, it looks like. And here we see another lamppost, another Art Deco lamppost by Salamone. And dogs are everywhere. And I guess they're looking for meat, you know, there's barbecues everywhere and we kind of feed them, but friendly dogs everywhere in the parks. They took us, we walked around the corner to a bakery. Of course, I could not participate because I'm gluten free, but it looked wonderful with the flat eyebrow that we have in New Florida and the stepping up and the geometry. So I went next door to the candy store and I had a good time. In South Hungary, we have another Salamone cemetery. As we see here, this is very large. Look, here's the entrance. This is just amazing. This circle with the cross and Jesus. Of course, here is the brick at the bottom to contrast. And they let us loose in the cemetery and we go looking around and quite beautiful. Now we go to the Matadero Municipal. Architect Francisco Salamone, 1938, the Municipal of Coronel Pringles. Matadero is a slaughterhouse, another slaughterhouse. So he was getting all these government commissions all over the state at the time. And this, we're having lunch in this building. This is the ceiling. We're having lunch in this building with the slaughterhouse iron on the ceiling, as you can see right here. Now this building had been restored for a community events, which is, it's all clean and nice and everyone's going to get some meat. I'm sitting right here, by the way, with Silvana Darling from West Palm Beach, of all things. And they don't serve me the meat. They tell me that today I can't have the meat, that some gravy that it had gluten. So I took one look at that and I said, no, I don't think I'm going to eat that. And of course they had a performance of locals doing a dance for us, a Brazilian dance. And more dogs with their cross legs, just adorable. Looking for some meat. So here we are at the City Hall building, which looks just like that building I told you to look at earlier. And, you know, very crisp, sharp lines, white with the clock. And this is in front of the building, always a big fountain, always architectural tile pattern floor. And now we get to see the lights. There was an exhibit where we saw pictures of these ceiling lights, but we didn't know what they meant. Salamone also designed them as well as these doors. And we got to see these lights in person and running around the building, taking pictures. Here's the lights in this hallway and the light, the architectural light in this stairwell. There's Gio Daughter from the tour guide from Copper Bridge. Here I am with Robin Rowe from Melbourne in front of the City Hall. And here I do a wide angle panorama of the view from the second floor. And here we'll see that there's the lampposts. There's our buses waiting for us. And just a magnificent view. More cows. We get to La Prida, of course, another light lamppost by Salamone. Everybody gets off the bus. And this amazing fountain. I mean, this is the structure. You've arrived in the city, has lights at night and perfect manicured bushes. And the kids stop, oh, take a picture. I love kids. And they threw down their bike and they posed. So we're at La Prida City Hall and we're entering down here. And they have the band playing for us, you know, and they waited for hours for us because we're traveling from long distances. We don't know what time we're going to arrive. And they welcome us and they play music. And we go in and we look at this wooden desk and look at this incredible light, this wall sconce, and a couch with a built-in ashtray on one side. One, two, three, and a rounded back and a little chevron here on the base, the stairwell. And this guy says to me, oh, come, I'll take you to a private office. Okay, I follow him, and he shows me this lamp. Oh, just beautiful. They're working in these buildings. It's an open city hall office with the original lighting. So we're on our way to the next cemetery. We're still in La Prida. And it's dark already. And one of the guests had gotten on the bus with us. And she was wearing a wedding gown. So everyone from our group went crazy because she started flowing her wedding gown in front of the cemetery. Nobody knew what was going on or why, but she was dancing like Loie Fuller. And everyone, I have pictures of everyone just taking pictures of her. And we started calling ourselves Salamoniacs, but we had to take her back. She somehow got on the bus. So we got back. It turned out we didn't know. They had a whole food reception for us with wine, but we didn't know. We just dropped her off. The building was illuminated in colors. Just look at how fabulous. But we drove away because we did not know there was a reception waiting for us. So the very next day, we made a video and we thanked them and said we were so sorry for missing the reception. We arrive at our next generation and we wake up in the morning. I'm having breakfast. I meet some Australians. You know, the wonderful thing is you're meeting from people from all over the world. You have your breakfast and lunch with different people. And now we go to the cemetery in Azul that I was praying and hoping we would get to see. Unfortunately, it wasn't a beautiful sunny day. It was a gray day. Now, if you Google this Salamone Azul Cemetery, there's fabulous pictures online, but I'm showing you my photos and my experience. So here's someone down here taking a picture. But it's cubism. It's just an amazing structure to me, and spiritual and holy. And just amazing. We got to go inside where there was a temple in the back. I found a bathroom that was open. This was my seating partner. She sat with me from New York on the bus for a good part of the time. But we see the up, down, we see the rounded corners. And so across the street before we got on the bus, there was a little window. It was a whole museum exhibit of architect Francisco Salamone, and this poster was in there showing you all his lightings. Get on the bus, and now we go to an abandoned slaughterhouse. This is not open. We could not get inside, but we did stop there. And everyone was taking pictures. You know, to get the right picture, you have to lay on the floor sometimes. And it was cold. I had to wear a cape. And I hear buzzing. And I noticed just to the left, there's beehives where they're making honey and they're selling honey. We get to the city hall of Rausch. And here they're highlighting the lights at night on the entrance. And there's a plaza across the street. Here's the lights. Here's the lamppost. And everyone's running in to get pictures. Look off the side. This looks like a building in LA, right? I showed you the building in LA before. And here we get to see the famous lighting and the doorways with the blue glass, the blue depression glass. Green, this is on a ceiling, straight above I'm shooting. It was November 8th in the park. And then we travel lunch. Now we're going to like a farm, a historical museum, but it was actually a farm and acres and acres. And of course, we had meat for lunch. it's just amazing. This time we had sausage, we had pork and meat and more meat. And here we are having lunch. And I went in inside and came out. So we have finally now arrived in Buenos Aires. We stay at the NH Hotel and everyone's unpacking. And to make up for that horrible room I had in Azul, I had booked online, and I wound up with a junior suite, four rooms and a balcony in this hotel, where other people had like the tiniest room and couldn't even walk around their bed. So I was so happy, 7 nights in a junior suite. This is my living room. So they told us to get all dressed up, that there would be video tonight, and we should, you know, wear our Art Deco best. And of course I came as an Egyptian queen, which I bought this outfit in Egypt and the headdress I made. And we went to the Edifico Safico. Edifico means building. So we're at the Safico building. And see if you can see me. I'm in two pictures. See if you can find me. Champagne. They had lights on buildings. I met with the commissioner, and I met Victoria, who's the granddaughter of the architect Walter Moll of Edifico Safico in 1934. Now, what was the strangest thing, she owns the building. If this was the United States, a big corporation owns a building, you know, and shareholders and stockholders, but she owns that Art Deco building. You know, business, she works in a business. She owns the building. Amazing. There's the hotel, and in the lobby, they have, you know, naturally the bull, the cow art, which, you know, we see here, we'll have flamingos in Florida where artists paint on that. An amazing staircase in the hotel. So in the morning, we have a lecture series. Once the conference begins, there's lecture series in the mornings and usually walking tour and bus tours in the afternoon. And here we'll see the historian, our guide Fabio. He was amazing, and he's showing us doorways and Art Deco apartment houses with streamlined gates in Buenos Aires. And he talks about Carlos Gardel, the French-Argentine singer and songwriter and actor, the most prominent in history of tango. And we've already learned about him. The music of Art Deco. He was a singer. He would sing the tango music. Look at that sexy, streamlined, sleek dance. So we started our first walking tour, and they take us to the big modern buildings, not the Art Deco, but to go see the city. So we have to cross over this bridge, and we're walking. And Brian and Julie Lorne from Melbourne, Australia, for years, they go to every Congress. They live, eat, and sleep Art Deco. They dress, and they are the photo ops of the world. I have many photo ops. I met them when I first went to one of the Congresses in New York, and you know they pose everywhere, and they're very, very famous. All year round, they travel all over the world and pose Art Deco. And there's tango in the streets, of course. It's Argentina. We walk across this very ultra-modern bridge, and they take us to the Cartoon Museum, the Museum de Humor, for a box lunch. And they had this amazing stained glass. But you see here the caricatures. And we go to an Art Deco apartment building. This is very ornate, but you'll see the 1, 2, 3, and you'll see columns and some very extraordinary stepping up and flat roofs. and doorways, Art Deco doorways and Art Deco lighting, ceilings. And, you know, even archways in the doorways, the moldings, the attention to the detail, the rounded corners of a curtain, minimal. And this is the elevator, and I'm, you know, taking pictures of me, of course, in the wood-carved elevator of the relief of the stylized flowers and water. So now it's nighttime and we're off to another adventure. And we go to an antique gallery reception with this extraordinary light on the ceiling. It's a two-story building, a huge building, Art Deco fluted ribbing here. And the 1, 2, 3, the inverted steps. And here I am with Roberta Newsom from New York, and we meet this architect, this crazy cool guy from Buenos Aires in Miami, and the director of the gallery, and we're drinking these orange liqueur drinks. We're having a good time. They were making these really great cocktails, and we could go up the stairs, and everything was for sale, but obviously we could not buy the furniture. In the morning, Catherine Hausman from New York, she used to be the president of the Art Deco Society of New York. She was selling some hair ornaments before the lecture started. And this is what the program would look like. And we had Christian Larson from the Metropolitan Museum of Art flew in. And he talked about the wonderful quality of the collection of the Metropolitan Museum of Art in Art Deco. It's just, it's not always on display. You know, they bring things out for different exhibits, but we got to see a wonderful presentation. Vicky Gold-Levy from Miami gave us a presentation on Cuba. And driving by, they never spoke about this, but we saw this. This is an emblem, a landmark sculpture that opens up at night. It's a giant metal flower by architect Eduardo Catalano. And it's the National United Plaza. And every time we would drive, we would see this. So I finally got a picture from the bus. Our next stop was the Grand Cafe Tortoni. And they say you can't come to Argentina without having coffee and tango here. So we had to wait outside. Here's the Cafe Tortango here, Tortoni on the cash register. And we're served espresso. We're downstairs in a basement. And we're treated to this lovely performance of tango. And I'm sitting in the first row. I'm very happy with my coffee. And every time we were driving, we'd see this wall public art cutout of Evita Perón. We stopped off at a flea market for like a half hour. I bought a pocketbook made of vinyl from 45 records, which I brought home with me as a souvenir. And we did a walking tour. We see the Art Deco stepping up, stepping down like the pyramid. We see the relief of the stylized figures. And we entered, this was kind of like a mall. We were in this building a few times. It's like a shopping plaza mall. A lot goes on here. This is not Art Deco, but quite exciting architecturally. And all kinds of things, you know, in the mall that I cannot have because I am gluten free. And we go to the Teatro Empire. And everyone's taking a picture of the mural of the naked men and the lovely ironwork curtain. And the ceiling. And then I said, hey, why don't we all get on stage and take a group picture, which they did, although I don't have it. Right outside our hotel was the Pertuti restaurant right on the corner. You know, we're in the city now and everything is right there at your fingertips, walking. And I had restaurant here many times and it was a bakery and restaurant, but just to show you the wonderful things that were gluten-free that I could have. The next morning, I met Therese Poletti from San Francisco, and she gave a lecture on the artist and the architect, the artist Timothy Pfluger. But you know, it was enough with the lectures. And I got antsy and I wanted to go take a walk out by myself and do some, just have an adventure. So I went and found this fruit market and this mural painted on this wall, this white, black and white mural on this wall. I went back to my room and look at the view from my junior suite. I was on the 7th floor. I had a whole patio and view of the city. So we went to Edifica del Molino, which was under construction. They were restoring this Art Deco palace building. Not yet though, we got in under construction. Everyone's running around taking pictures. Just palace buildings, staircases, and stained glass windows. And then we went for lunch at the Club Espanol. Here we see the C and the E in the floor, the Art Deco floor. And they took us to the second floor we had before we had the lunch, and we're taking, it's a theater. And we were served a lovely fish lunch with wine. Everything is wine and cheese and meat, but today we had fish. But you can see this in the restaurant, all the hanging meat. So now we're in the theater district, you know, think of 42nd Street, where there's buildings everywhere and activity everywhere and a neon everywhere. And we see these rounded buildings with banding stripes. And we go into this theater, we see the lightning bolt. And I see a Starbucks. And I say, sorry, I got to go next door to this rainbow Starbucks and have the a Starbucks coffee. But the ceiling of the theater, lovely. Metropolitan. This looks just like a Salamone cemetery building. The Met, very stark, very modern. And we go into this one building that just looks like a doorway. We don't know what's in there. And oh, what a surprise. Just look at this ironwork. Notice the balance of the Art Deco and the flooring and the triangles, the stripes, the staircase, and this stained glass window. I even like it with the people's pictures in there, kind of balancing out. Looking down, looking up. And now I wanted to see what the other hotel looked like. So the people who didn't stay in my hotel, where I had the junior suite, the NH, was one right around the corner. So here I am wearing a black and white dress, and this was their lobby. So I thought, wow, can't ask for a more fun photo than that. And I meet Janista Davidson from England. She's called the Art Deco Traveler. She travels around the world and then writes books about where she visits. So 1 month she travels and 1 month she writes, all out of England. And we've ended up being very good friends. And it was Tango night. We go to the theater. And it was not Art Deco, obviously, but quite opulent. We had a sit-down, amazing dinner. And we were going to learn to do the tango. We got a partner and we had tango lessons. And we're treated again to an amazing night of tango. Movement and swirling. I'm pretty tired the next morning. I mean, I really am. And it looks cool. Everyone's wearing a jacket and we're carrying books with us. And we meet in front of the Buenos Aires Economic Council, which we kind of like had a sign in, you know, like an airport, you know, security to get into the Economic Council. There's this major Art Deco government building that we had special access to with the lighting and the entrances and just amazing ironwork, 1, 2, 3 chevron triangles, staircases, frosted glass, rounded corners. And they're looking up blueprints. And at this point, I don't even feel good. I have to just sit down. Everyone's being treated to these lectures. And I'm tired. I'm really not, I'm tired, but I continue to take pictures of the architecture of the building, which was outstanding. And we go to this highest point, this lookout, and we're able to see the whole city. Wow. Wow. That's a bustling city, Buenos Aires, Argentina. And I went all the way to the top point. And then you have to swirl down by yourself. On the second floor there of that building, where they had to put on some masks. In fact, I'm wearing the same shirt. And we put on for a little costume for photos for the theater. So we go back into that mall. And we're taking more pictures. And we take a little walking tour. And it says, yo creo exclusivamente en el gobierno de la opinión pública. I believe exclusively in the government of public opinion, a democracy. So this is on the back of this Art Deco sculpture that's in the middle of the building there that we're doing a walking tour. And Roberta Newsom is tired. We were so tired. We're waiting to get into a bank now, which we get access to, the Banca Electronica. We get to the yacht club dinner. And it's just wonderful how everyone's having a dinner on the water. And the next morning, the ICANN's board of directors meets with Adriana Piastrellini. She is the president of Art Deco Buenos Aires. And here's the board of directors. We have Robin Groh from Australia, Neil Nesley from Los Angeles, Gio Dorda from Cuba and Brazil, Adriana is Buenos Aires, Joe Londi is president ICAD's board, and Roberta Newsom is the secretary from New York. And I'm at the meeting, so I'm taking the picture. We get to go to a museum, a car museum. And the anti-car museums. And of course, Julie and the Lords are ready for another photo op. We're having a box lunch outside in the garden. And now we get to go to the Museo de Arte Latinoamericano de Buenos Aires, MALBA, MALBA, a Museum of Modern Art. So we go up the elevator, it's a big place. And we look down, there's a swimming pool exhibit. And it turns out there's people under the water. So you look down, you could see people in the water. So I go downstairs and I see people walking into this room. And then I look up and there's people taking pictures of us. And there I am pretending to be in the water. It's one of our last nights now. I'm with Joanna Nevesny, Neil's wife from Los Angeles, and we get all dressed up for our last dinner. There's more Art Deco people. Can't remember their names right now. And we go to the Victoria Ocampo House. Victoria was a prominent writer. She was a literary magazine owner. And she had a house built that was influenced by Le Corbusier that was so modern and so minimal. And we went to visit this house. Very minimal, very modern. It was by Alejandro Bustillo in 1929. He didn't even like the architecture, but she loved it. She wanted a very modern, so ahead, forward thinker. And we're in the building. And here's Janista and Joelle from Copperbridge, Vicky Goldlevy again. We're all dressed up on our final dinner. And we arrive. And we all get up and on the staircase and they take all these pictures and videos of us. And the ceiling has wonderful pyramid steps. And we dance the night away. The next day, everyone who's going on to Uruguay, but everyone kind of goes their own way. I was going home and I spent the day with Janista, because our planes didn't leave till late in the day. So we said, let's just get in a cab and see where it takes us. And we had a 30-minute ride, and it was like a dollar. And we found this botanical gardens, miles, acres and acres. We had a lovely day. We walked over this bridge. There was a museum, and they had a photo exhibit of Diego Rivera and Frida Kahlo, his wife. And of course, Victoria Ocampo, who is a writer. And there I am, back at home. God bless America. There is no place like home. Thank you so much for coming tonight. God bless you. If you have any questions, I'll be happy to ask. If you'd like to be on my email list, just email me, SharonDelRay@gmail.com. SharonDelRay@gmail.com. If you have any questions, anyone, it's been so good to see you. Thank you for staying with me all this time.
Sounds like you had a wonderful experience.
Yes, it really, really was. But it was, they have you going morning, noon, and night. And then I have to go home and write in my journal and write things down and get up early for breakfast and it's exhausting.
Thanks for sharing it with us.
And now we're planning 2023 in Palm Beach County, April 28, 29, 30. So I've already met with the Wiener Museum of Decorative Arts, but we'll go stop there, and all the places we'll go in Palm Beach, like the Armory Arts Center and the Cultural Council Building, and you know, the Lake Worth Playhouse, and, you know, show the international people the Art Deco of the Palm Beaches. It's very, very exciting in 2 years for me.
Thank you.
Hi, Sharon. It's Barbara and Ron Sickman. It was lovely.
Thank you. Our Congress will be open to locals. So we'll have the international people, locals, and the first night, Friday night, we're going to have an Egyptian soiree. So come to the Egyptian soiree in 2023. All right, if everybody's good, I want you to keep wearing your masks, even though they tell you you don't have to, for me, okay? So we'll all be here in 2023. Keep wearing the masks, you know, not amongst your family, but when you go in a crowd of people you don't know, keep wearing your masks, keep staying safe, and
get vaccinated.
Thank you.
Bye.
I
enjoyed
it. Ellie and Jerry. Hi. Thank you, Judith. Thank you, Roseanne. Thank you, Brad. Joe Feldman. Brad. You'll have to email me, Brad, and tell me how it was. I can't hear you. You mute it, I can't hear you at all. Nope, can't hear you. You'll email me if you have any comments.
Oh, I said we were in Buenos Aires in February 2020.
Oh, okay. So did you have any similar experiences?
We saw some Art Deco buildings, not so much Art Nouveau, not so much Art Deco.
You have to know they're driving us to where it is.
Yeah, we were only there about 4 days, 3 nights, because we were basically in Brazil to go to graduation of my wife's her son's wife, who graduated from dental school there. So we just did a side trip to Buenos Aires before.
It's very exciting to see Art Nouveau. We have no Art Nouveau in the United States.
Yeah.
It just wasn't popular here. But very exciting.
Yeah, I have to talk to you further about it. It's a very interesting trip, though. Anyway, I've been there before on business. I was there almost 2 months on business before, in the 90s.
My dog wants my attention so bad.
Oh. Yeah, I heard your dog barking before.
She's been pretty good.
We have a dog also, but he doesn't make that much noise.
Well, she'll be a year on Saturday, so she's learning. She's pretty good.
Oh, the new dog?
Yeah, she'll be a year on Saturday. I have her 9 months.
Oh, okay.
She's a year old? Yeah, I've had her 9 months as a puppy. It hasn't been easy.
As a puppy, yeah. puppies too. Yeah.
Puppy.
You know, the hotel we stayed at in Buenos Aires is very interesting. Just a note to everybody, if they're listening, we stayed at this French hotel in Buenos Aires in Recoleta.
Ooh.
And, you know, Recoleta's cemetery, of course, is very famous. A lot of very beautiful Art Deco monuments there.
Wow.
Inside the cemetery. And the hotel we stayed at, when we first got in the hotel, we saw a picture of Eva Perón. As soon as we got in the hotel, I thought, oh, that's nice. Well, of course, she's very famous in Buenos Aires, but I thought it was a little unusual to have a picture of Eva Perón as soon as we got in the hotel. And we found out later that actually before she married Juan Perón, she lived in that hotel on the sixth floor in when it was an apartment building.
Wow.
And we were on the fourth floor. She was on the sixth floor. It's very bit of history there, you know, and very interesting.
Yeah, you know, there's a reason for everything. There really is. You just don't always know what it is. That's why we study history. That's the beauty of it. It's so interesting.
Did you go to the Eva Perón Museum when you were in Buenos Aires?
No. The day that I went to the Botanical Garden was a free day because everybody went to a tour of the Opera House.
Right.
But I just wanted to, I was too tired for one more lecture.
It looks like an exhausting trip.
Yeah. So Janice and I just said, oh, let's just go walk some nice garden, calm. Right. And that's what we did. And then we discovered things like the museum and a restaurant, outdoor restaurant. I mean, you know, everything is new to us, so everything is exciting.
Yeah, Buenos Aires is a great city. I mean, it's a very cosmopolitan city.
I don't know that I'm going back, you know, that I would go back, have the time to go back, or travel anywhere right now.
Yeah, if you go back, you have to go to the Eva Perón Museum. It's very interesting. Very interesting.
Yeah, well, there's a whole world out there I haven't seen.
Oh, it's very European. Of course, many Italian, many German immigrants also, English even. You know, it's very, very European.
It's all multicultural, absolutely.
Very, very much so.
And
we're going to sign off, but great, great lecture, Sharon.
Thank you.
My first one I've been able to hear, actually.
Well, I have them on, this is a recording. I'll have this on YouTube soon. So
I'm going to look at it again because I missed a couple parts.
That's what I've been doing. I've just been posting them on YouTube there they are.
I look forward to going on a tour or meeting you sometime in the future also.
Yes. When we're back to tours. I'm not there yet, but.
Yeah, I know. Do you think it's going to be later this year at some point?
I imagine, you know, a season. Let's see how the variant goes. Let's see how everything.
Things are opening up. Things are opening up.
We won't be disappointed.
Yeah. Okay, Sharon. Take care.
Bye-bye. Thank you.
Bye.
And how are you, Norma?
Oh, she's good too. She's cooking right now. She's in the background.
All right. Thank you. How about Ellie and Jelly is still here? That's to unmute.
Take care.
Thank you. Yes, no, you're still there. Maybe they walked away. Yes, to unmute. All right, I'm gonna sign off now. Mwah.